Brothers and sisters, I don't know what ship you may have come over on, but we in the same boat now. On Monday, April 4th, this nation and many places around the world paid tribute to the final work of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., a celebration of his life work to force this nation to live up to the highest standards of social justice and civil rights and human rights and workers' rights. I want to thank the temporary governor of Wisconsin because he brought to the attention of this nation the meanness and special brand of evil being visited on working people by this new brand of Republican leadership. He has forced or reinforced what many of us knew. This assault on workers is a fight between the powerful and those they seek to make powerless. Well, they have jumped on the wrong crowd. Dr. King's life ended 43 years ago in Memphis, Tennessee, carrying out the mission that his life was dedicated to. Fighting for workers' rights, fighting for civil rights, fighting for human rights, and fighting for social justice. Dr. King knew that the public services and workers in general are important to our society, and that organized labor is the vehicle into the middle class. But he saw the injustice, the unfairness, the inequity for all when workers were powerless. The lives and struggles of 1,300 sanitation workers symbolized to him the great contradiction in our social and economic system. Men who worked every single day but could not raise themselves out of poverty. Something wrong with that picture. But Dr. King understood that the reason for that was simple. They did not have their union. They were not recognized as a union. They could not bargain. They could not speak for themselves. They had no voice. If Dr. King was alive today, he would be standing with the workers and students and citizens of Wisconsin. He would be marching with the workers and citizens of Ohio, Indiana, New Hampshire, Maine, Tennessee, Michigan, and every other place where workers' rights are being taken away or threatened or denied. In a nation where 1% of the people own 33% of the wealth and the remaining 99% of us have to scuffle for our share of what's left, there's something wrong with that picture.